Kidney stones are prevalent, impacting around 1 in 5 males and 1 in 10 females by the time they reach 70 years of age. Fortunately, there are available interventions to proficiently address the majority of these stones. Furthermore, it's possible to adopt measures to hinder the recurrence of kidney stones. The process of kidney stone formation begins when there are elevated levels of specific substances, such as calcium, oxalate, cysteine, or uric acid, present in the urine. Kidney stones can also develop when these substances are within normal levels, particularly if urine production is low, h. insufficient fluid intake. These substances crystallize into tiny crystals, which find a place in the kidney to anchor themselves, gradually growing in size to become a kidney stone. Such a stone can persist in the kidney for extended periods, causing neither symptoms nor kidney damage. Generally, the stone will eventually navigate through the urinary tract and exit the body through the urine. Should the stone become lodged and obstruct urine flow, it can lead to pain. Notably, larger stones might not pass naturally and could necessitate a minimally invasive procedure for removal. There are specific illnesses, dietary patterns, and medications that can heighten the likelihood of kidney stone formation. Additionally, if kidney stones run in your family, your risk might be elevated. It's worth noting that experiencing a kidney stone once increases the probability of having another one in the future. Occasionally, a kidney stone may not exhibit any symptoms and might only be detected during imaging procedures conducted for different reasons. These stones can exist in the kidneys for years without causing any noticeable effects. Nevertheless, symptoms usually arise when the stones traverse the urinary tract. Pain. Pain represents the predominant symptom during the passage of a kidney stone. Typically, pain occurs primarily with obstruction, which arises when a stone hinders or blocks the flow of urine from the kidney to the bladder. The intensity of pain can vary, ranging from a mild ache to such discomfort that hospital treatment becomes necessary. Generally, the pain's severity fluctuates, persisting without complete relief until addressed. Episodes of intense pain, referred to as renal colic, commonly endure for 20 to 60 minutes. Pain can manifest on the flank, the side between the ribs and hip, or in the lower abdomen, and it might radiate towards the groin, blood in the urine. The majority of individuals with kidney stones will experience blood in the urine, medically referred to as hematuria. The urine might appear pink or reddish, or the presence of blood might only be detectable upon examining a urine sample under a microscope. If you observe blood in your urine, it's advisable to inform your healthcare provider. They can arrange for tests to determine whether a kidney stone or another factor is responsible. Small stones. Some patients might pass what's often referred to as gravel or sand, which comprises multiple small stones present in the urine. Additional symptoms. Additional symptoms of kidney stones can encompass nausea or vomiting, discomfort during urination, and a pressing urge to urinate. Kidney stones are usually diagnosed based on your symptoms, physical examination, and imaging tests, such as computed tomography and ultrasound. The approach to treating an obstructive kidney stone is contingent upon factors like its size, location, your pain level, and your ability to stay hydrated. When the stone is small enough to likely pass, pain is manageable, and you can maintain fluid intake and nourishment. Your healthcare provider will probably recommend home-based treatment. In cases of intense pain or nausea, more potent pain relief medications and intravenous IV fluids, typically administered in a hospital setting, become necessary. Hospitalization is also required if you have a fever, as it could indicate a potentially severe infection. Home management. Addressing a kidney stone at home involves pain management as required, using medication to facilitate the stone's passage, if suggested by your healthcare provider, and filtering your urine to retain the stone for analysis once it is successfully passed. Pain relief. You have the option to use over-the-counter pain relief medication until the kidney stone passes. This can include non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, NSAIDs, like ibuprofen or naproxen. However, it's important to consult your doctor before using them, particularly if you have specific health conditions that might contraindicate NSAID usage. Facilitating stone passage. Various medications are available to potentially expedite the time it takes for a kidney stone to pass, such as tamsulosin. Depending on your situation and the stone's size, your healthcare provider might recommend taking one of these medications for a few weeks to aid in passage. It's crucial to understand that these medications won't lead to immediate passage. It might still take several days or more. Straining your urine. It's likely that your healthcare provider will suggest straining your urine to retrieve the stone. After collecting it, you should bring the stone to your healthcare provider for laboratory analysis. Identifying the type of kidney stone is vital for planning preventive treatments. Ureteroscopy. Ureteroscopy is a common procedure that uses a thin telescope, which is passed through the urethra and bladder into the ureter and kidney. This allows the doctor to see the stone and remove it, or to break it into smaller pieces that can pass more easily. Ureteroscopy is often used to remove stones blocking the ureter and sometimes for small stones in the kidney. Shockwave lithotripsy, SWL. This procedure involves directing high-energy shockwaves toward the stone. These sound waves pass through the skin and internal body tissues and release energy at the stone surface. This energy causes the stone to break into fragments that can be more easily passed in the urine. Shockwave lithotripsy is a reasonable option for many people who need help breaking up a stone. Lithotripsy is particularly good for stones 1 cm or less in the kidney and upper ureter. Shockwave lithotripsy is not effective for treating large or hard stones. You may require medication to make you sleepy and reduce pain during this treatment, although this depends upon the type of equipment used. Percutaneous nephrolithotomy, PNL. This is a minimally invasive surgical procedure in which a small telescope is passed through the skin of the back and into the kidney to remove the stone. Very large or complex stones, or large stones that do not respond to shockwave lithotripsy or ureteroscopy, may need to be removed this way.